Well, I got into glass blowing, it must have been 99. And I got just doing glass beads while I was waiting tables at local restaurants and stuff. And I just totally fell in love with it immediately. And then once I fell in love with that, I started working for local shops, like local novelty shops, doing production glass for them. And I'd always be going to the glass supply stores, just being really nosy, asking everybody what they do. And I met a guy who had worked in Santa Clara, had owned a company making these helium neon lasers. So I started working with him for a little while as an independent contractor, did that for a couple years, and then just going back and forth, you know, kind of being scared to dive in head first. Oh, I love glassblowing because it's such an old art form. And when I first got into glassblowing, I met a lot of artists who had kind of an ego about them. And art in general, my family, I have a background of a lot of people in my family are artists. And I was always kind of intimidated by that. And when I got into the glassblowing, I realized that there was so much to know about glassblowing that anybody that called themselves a quote-unquote master glassblower, it was probably just because they hadn't have opened up their horizons enough to see what was out there. And so it was, to me, it's like an art form that there's always room for improvement and there's always room to learn more. I could spend the rest of my life, I wish I had started earlier because I'm 31 now and I've been doing it for about 12 years. And I could blow glass until I'm, you know, 200 years old and there'd still be more to learn. So it's just an awesome opportunity. And there's not as much of the ego thing about it. I mean, there's definitely people don't want other people to be copying their stuff exactly. But because it's such an old art form, I heard someone say that, you know, you imitate until you integrate the skills into your skill sets. And then once you have those skills, then you can innovate. So it's like almost like learning a language. Like you have to learn how to talk to the glass. You have to learn how to communicate with the glass. You have to learn, you know, what your boundaries are, physical boundaries are, and what the physical boundaries, the physical property boundaries of the glass are. So you create this relationship. Like I feel like I have a deeper relationship with glass than probably anything else in my life.